Back at the Georgia Coliseum, the Utah Utes head back into the arena to be crowned champions. So Utah defends its title from a year ago. Alabama and Michigan tie for second. Georgia finishes way down in fifth. Let's go over to Julianne now, who's standing by with the victorious Utes.
A lot of people were doubting you guys this year. You've had a rough year with injuries and things happening. Did you doubt yourselves at all?
You can't doubt yourself. If you go in with a negative attitude, it'll kill you. We just went out there and had the time of our life. We didn't even expect this.
Yeah, I think we had a lot of confidence coming in just to go in and do the best that we could.
So is it that much more special to everything you've been through and now you're national champions?
Yeah, it's been an unbelievable year and one that we didn't even know if we'd be here when we started the season. And to be here and to have won is unimaginable.
Congratulations, Utah.
And what a special day for these young women. The University of Michigan breaking into that elite top three for the first time ever. But once again, it's Utah alone at the top. The Utes winning their ninth NCAA championship in 14 years. For Julianne McNamara, I'm Andrea Joyce saying so long from Athens.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1995 NCAA Women's Gymnastics Championship has been sponsored by Charles Schwab and Company, helping investors help themselves. 100% cotton wrinkle-free Dockers. And by Tenactin. If you want a medicine that acts tough, get Tough Actin Tenactin.
Next Saturday, CBS Sports brings you the NCAA Men's Gymnastics Championships at 2:30 Eastern Time. And coming up next, live third-round coverage of the LPGA Sprint Championship. Congratulations to Utah, the 1995 national champions. And for Greg Marsden and company, rest assured, winning never gets old.